Factual documents are ubiquitous, such as news articles, academic papers, and product descriptions. We discover that documents are usually connected in a graph structure. We call such a data document graph. Below is an illustration of academic citation graph. Each vertex on the graph is an academic paper, which is a document. If one paper cites the other, we draw a link between them. Similarly, we have news article hyperlink graph and product contextual graph. Such kind of document graph has two modalities. One is a corpus of documents. The other is graph structure. This tutorial focuses on document graph representation learning. We aim to infer document embeddings so that they can preserve both contextualized semantics contained in documents and graph connectivity across documents. Given document graph as input, we aim to design some existing models, such as pre-trained language models or topic models. As the output, we obtain document embeddings, and we hope they can fulfill different tasks, such as text classification, citation recommendation, and question answering. The first scenario of document graph is a static document graph. Existing works can be split into cascaded and nested architectures. The left-hand side figure is the cascaded architecture. We first use language models to encode each individual document, and then we apply graph neural networks on top to aggregate embeddings. On the right-hand side, we have nested architecture. Language models and graph neural networks are nested at each layer to better integrate textual documents and graph connectivity. The second scenario is textual age document graph, where documents sometimes appear on edges instead of vertices. The left figure is online user product review graph. If a user buys product, there is a link between them, and the corresponding textual review appears on the edge. On the right-hand side, we have email communication graph. Two people exchange emails, and those emails are textual documents appearing on the corresponding edge. The third scenario is a temporal document graph. Documents are usually created over time. For example, at the very beginning, we have four documents. Maybe later, two more documents, E and F, are created and containing links to existing documents. And further, one more document, G, is further created. We also can learn such topic evolution. We can also use those document graphs to do some tasks, such as text classification. We can also focus on citation recommendation. Overall, this tutorial has four parts. For the first part, we will introduce document graph as well as preliminaries. For the second part, we will introduce pre-trained language model-based document graph models. And then, thirdly, we will introduce topic model-based document graph models. Fourth, we will introduce some real-world applications, challenges, and future directions.